Masters, madams, ladies, and lords, welcome back to another playthrough. I guess I'm gonna do more playthroughs on home. I'm not sure, because none of you guys have basically voted against it or anything. So I guess I might do some more home videos. This one, I guess, will be another home video, guys. So welcome back to home. PlayStation home. Updated a whole bunch. They do update on Wednesdays, guys, so they bring out a lot of new places and challenges. They update the challenges after, I think, 3 to 4 weeks after it's been over or so, but obviously our challenges aren't over, as you can see, because I have the actual challenge screen up. Sorry, guys, my nose, it just because of my allergies. Ugh, I hate this so much, guys. Anyway, basically, we are going to do some more challenges. I'll show you around my Arctic yacht, and I will show you our life points, little crown that you get. This crown, allows you to go to any space that is in the thing. Well, not any space. You can have your own public spaces or have a friend who has the public spaces. You can go to clubs, whether they be yours or a friend's, if you're in the club. And then they have public spaces as well. That's how you get the points, the life points. And, well, I would say they have some really neat rewards and things in there that you can use your points for to buy. The thing is that you might want to save your points and get up to level 10, because there is an apartment within the prizes, and you can't get it until level 10, which it sucks, because you have to buy it for 500 points, but you have to wait till 10. I have 600 something odd points. I don't know. Or even points. Whatever. But I have over 600 points. So I'm saving up my points and waiting till I get to level 10. And right now I'm at level 7. Guys, level 7. Okay. So I'll get on with it. We'll get on with our challenges and I'll show you around the yacht and everything. So I hope you guys enjoy. Okay. Oh. I'm sorry, guys, I gotta adjust the camera angle and everything. Gotta adjust it there. Okay, so, let's see what's on our agenda today. Okay, gone fishing, tree hugger, take the tour, apprentice duelist, and, I screwed in the score, which is okay. So, all of these I can actually do, but, okay, I'm gonna go to gone fishing. Hold on. Let me change my character's outfit really quick, guys. I don't really want to be in my Silent Night outfit, because this is more of a Christmas outfit, and it's very provocative and all this, and a lot of men keep trying to mess with me when I'm in this outfit, so I'm gonna change into another outfit, guys. So I think we're gonna go with my Japanese outfit that I just recently got, and it goes well with the place that we're gonna go to. So, oh yeah, I gotta go into storage, because for some reason it's in here, guys. It's in here. I've got to get her cat ears to come off, but they're not in that. I forgot it's in this one. So, yeah, this is her hair that goes with this outfit. So, yeah. Well, the gloves don't go, and neither do the shoes. She had white boots that apparently go with this outfit. Sorry, guys, I sneezed. Yeah. Thanks if you said bless you. I don't know if you guys did or not, can't tell. I'm gonna go with her demon sword that she gets from the space. From, the place that we're gonna go. You have to, do a challenge to get it. Which, I might show you guys later in another video. So, you can see how to get it. So, this is her outfit. But, she gets a parasol if I go over to my personal items in my inventory. It's a ways down, though. Okay, there we go. There's her parasol. So in a moment, she'll have her parasol. And she looks so adorable. She looks like an actual doll at one point. Oh, the screen's finally up. Can I get 10 points for this? For watching? I thought watching the screen would get us points, but I don't think it does. And her parasol's not connected yet. I might have to wait a second. That's not going to show. I guess we'll just go into the challenges. Challenge menu again. And go to this. Oh, there's her actual parasol. She looks adorable when she has her parasol. So I'm going to level up sometime today. Possibly after I get this one challenge done. But it'll be worth it, guys. So all I have to do in this challenge, Gone Fishing, is not what you really expect. Okay, in this game, what you do is you actually catch 3 fish. But the thing is, it's one of those, you know, paper scoopers where they have the really thin material and it's round and it looks kind of like a magnifying glass, and you take it and you try to scoop up the fish with it. That's what we're trying to do in this specific challenge on home. So you're taking one of those. I don't know if you guys can see it. Oh, I can see it. It's here. You take this, the paper scooper, and you try to catch 3 fish before it tears and rips and then you lose all your fish. What you do is after you catch 3, you put them in a bowl that's in the actual water. And it'll count it and basically tell you that, oh, you've caught 3 fish. Okay, so your challenge is complete after that. Now, if you don't catch 3 fish in the first time, it's all right. You can do it again, and it'll count it again towards how many you've caught. So don't worry about it. Like, say you caught 2, you just need 1 more, and your little scooper here breaks. What happens is you can redo the game to do this, catch 1 fish, and you've gotten all 3. So it's not like you have to do it all over again. It's not like that at all. So that's what we're going to do. Then as well do Spinland again, guys, because it's so weird. And all we have to do is get 6 trees, but you know me, I'm going to do all 12. Find all 12 trees, and then after that, go save my points and possibly do the next challenge. For Yurga to say, yeah, I guess I should get it on. That sounded wrong. Okay, but moving on with the challenges. Right now I'm waiting for it to load up the actual plays and sit there and say, do you want to relocate? So, I might actually do this video in 2 parts, depending, because it's taking forever, and I don't want this to be too long. Now there's the screen that says, do you want to relocate? Yes, I want to relocate. Okay. So, guys, we're going to go moving on with our challenges. If there are any challenges that you want me to do, like, that don't have to consist of this, just random challenges like the Cinnamon Challenge or Chubby Bunny Challenge or something of that nature, if there's something that you want me to do in a video, leave a comment below and I will get around to doing more of what you guys suggest. Some of the challenges that you want me to do, yeah. No matter how stupid they are, I'll do them. I don't back down from a challenge. So, guys, I hope to see your comments. Okay, so now we're gonna wait for this to load up. And hopefully we'll get the bonfire. Oh, it looks like they're getting ready for a festival here in Edo. The great Edo of Nippon. Of Nippon. Yeah, Nippon. Nippon. I don't know how to say that. Oh well, but it looks like they've decorated it for the festival. So yay! They finally got the festival here instead of just in Edo. Okay, so we're gonna get on with our challenge. But we might actually end up doing a dance, too. I don't know. So, where are we gonna go? Let's see what's around here. How's the dance there? I guess we'll join the dance circle first. Just so we can see if we actually get... Guys. Okay, I guess I can take a picture of her. Okay, so we got a picture. Oh, we gotta wait for it to load again. if I'm not mistaken, after joining the Agile Dance for the bonfire, I do believe you're supposed to get part of the dance, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know. I'm not really sure, guys, but, like I said, every Wednesday they do upload, or basically they do maintenance, and they upload new items, new spaces, new things to do, so they do things for seasons, too. Like, you know, recently they've had a summer version of the Acorns Park, which I know I haven't really taken you guys there. They do change it every time. They do a special event, like they've done a birthday event, they've done a winter event, Christmas event, they did a soccer event, a football event. Yeah, they've really done a lot of different things. So we're going to clap now. Okay, we're gonna end this just because I'm here to do the challenge, guys, but I don't know if we actually got anything or not. I didn't get any hero points. Which, I know where I have to go to get the hero points. Oh, look, okay, there's the actual place that we need to go. We need to go to the goldfish scooper.
Yinji.
As we're going to do this, okay, so what we do is we take the scooper and we move it, maneuver it, and everything. We try to get underneath the fish. If you can't, that's okay. We don't have to get... Oh, look, I caught three right then and there. Okay, so we take it to the bowl here, like I said. Challenge complete! Yeah, I know I completed the challenge, but I do like to make sure that I can get some more. Just in case. Oh, it broke. It's okay, guys. We already finished it, so... Oh, yep, I apparently got a reward, guys, so that's good. I have the rewards now challenged. Oh, page up. Oh, now I can get a new reward. Well, three new rewards, actually. So we're gonna go over here. Yay, we found it. That's level 4 in the tier. So we're gonna get one of the two items at the top before the actual apartment. So, guys, next level I complete, I'll actually end up having everything, including the apartment. So, I want to go with the toucan companion, just because I like toucans. They're interesting. So, the next thing we're gonna get is the actual swords and shield one. Cross sword. And then we're gonna get the last prize in the actual bottom tier. So yeah! There we go! We got some new items, guys! Okay, so with that, we can get the 100 up there. Hero points, let me explain that. With hero points, what you do is, like I said, I didn't explain the other, thing. Okay, once you get the demon sword and everything, or you're working towards getting your demon sword, you go to a suspicious old man, and he'll give you a box. Well, he sits there and says that you need to get 8 tiles of the great blue centipede. Well, what happens is you go in there, but if you only have the bamboo sword, it's best to let someone who actually has the demon sword or a better sword or weapon choice in general that is compatible with the game to basically do the work. I'm not saying that you can't go in and hit the centipede. I'm just saying it's better for you just to hang back because you will be defeated really easily if you only have the bamboo sword. So if there are people out there that are willing to help you, they can take care of the centipede, and all you would have to do is run to the Pillar of Light. And it will give you the points, too. So, don't think I'm trying to belittle you or anything. I'm not. It's just, it's easier for you to get points by having somebody who actually has the sword to help you. Because the bamboo sword doesn't do a lot of damage with the Great Centipede. So, yeah. And then once you do that, you can do your own individual thing. After you get all 8, you get the sword. Once you get the sword, you can do your own individual run, where you do an individual battle with no group. And you can get your own points that way. You can get Ryu too, or Ryu, or whatever it's pronounced. But it's money that you can spend with a suspicious old woman. She sells a lot of things. So yeah. You can use their points to do different things. So, yeah. I think I'm going to end this one here, guys. And do another part to it. So that we can all get the challenges and get to the Arctic yacht and everything like this. Yay. So, I love you guys. Like I said, leave a message down below or a comment down below to see what challenge you want me to do. Or suggest some things. I don't mind. Also, like and share, like if you like it, and don't forget to subscribe, guys. I really appreciate the 8 who've already subscribed to me. Thank you so much, guys. I appreciate it. So, question of the day. What culture is your favorite culture? Mine happens to be Japanese, as you can kind of tell. So, leave that comment down below too if you really want to answer that question. What is your favorite culture? Just let me know what you guys think. Mine happens to be Japanese, so yeah. So I'm gonna say peace out here from Katsuki Agami. I love you guys. See you later, sirs and madams, and we'll have fun next time.